In this quick tutorial, I will show you how I use images with different exposure for my artwork. Here I have three images with three different exposures. For this particular demonstration, I would like to keep underexposed image or darkest image as my main image. I like the subtlety of background, but the girl looks a little too dark. So I will start by choosing image with medium exposure. I will click on option Select All, Edit Copy, then click on the original image and choose option Edit Paste. In the Layers panel, you will see that this image placed as a second layer. Now I'm going to choose the lightest image or overexposed image, and again I'm going to click on Select All, Edit Copy. I'm going to select the original image again and click on option Edit Paste. Now I'm going to have three layers with three different exposures. For now I'm going to click on Visibility mode to hide middle range image, and here I want to select the girl. And to do this I'm going to use one of the selection tools. I'm going to click on Magic Wand and then click on option Select Subject. I'm not going to get a great result, but it's not that important for me right now. So after this, I'm going to click on option Apply Mask, and you can see that now I extracted the girl image and successfully placed it on a darker background. If I will zoom a little closer, I can see that my extraction wasn't all that great. So to fix this problem, I'm going to click on thumbnail of the mask. I'm going to select brush, make sure that it's a soft brush. I'm going to adjust opacity to about 50%, and I'm going to slightly work on my extraction. Now I'm going to select mid-range layer, and I want to apply reverse mask on this layer. So I'm going to hold Alt on my keyboard and click on option Apply Mask. Another way of doing that, just click on option Apply Mask, select thumbnail of the mask, and simply choose option Invert. Now I'm going to select girl layer again. We'll make sure that I am on the middle range layer. I'm going to select a brush tool again, make sure it's white. I'm going to keep opacity low, maybe slightly enlarge the size of my brush. Now I'm going to gently brush on areas I want to reveal a little bit more. An advantage of this technique that I can manually highlight the areas I want to highlight and keep dark areas as dark as I would like. For the next step, I'm going to make just a couple of more adjustments. I'm going to select the lightest layer, again make sure that I am on the thumbnail of the mask. Now I'm going to switch color to black, and I'm slightly going to remove some of the lightest areas because it's simply a little too bright. I'm going to zoom in. Now I'm going to remove some of the highlights from the girl's face. So I'm going to reduce opacity and brush over the brightest areas. And if I want to continue to make more adjustments, I can do that quite easily because the content with different exposure currently divided by three layers. So if I want to make a girl a little darker, I simply need to reduce opacity of this layer. It's simply a great way to control different exposures in order to create a dynamic, dramatic effect.